We're moving on to round number two, Eats, Beats, and Rhymes, another episode of Who Do You Got, every Monday, 8 o'clock Eastern Standard Time. We're doing De La Soul, Stakes Is High versus The Far Side Lab, Cabin, California. We just got to talk about tracks, bro. There's no other way to go around. We can't talk philosophy. We can't talk about who had the better, like, you know, overall career. And we're not doing any of those kind of questions tonight. We're talking about two specific projects. I wanted to talk about fire-ass songs. Let's just put them back-to-back and see which fucking song you guys like better than the other. DJ Hobo, if you don't mind, we're going to talk about De La Soul's The Business featuring Common versus Running by The Far Side.
Not that we talk business, I mean politics on this show, but it's worth noting that The Business was on Obama's playlist.
Was it really? The irony of The Business is, again, I head nodded it earlier this evening, is that it's technically a single. So this could still be the battle of the singles. It just happens to be a B-side. It happens to be a B-side, but no one can deny, in fact, that this song made a lot of noise, even without a video. Beats fire. You could have convinced me it wasn't Dilla, but it's not Dilla, apparently. It's fucking that. That should sound like a Dilla beat to me. Like, I don't know why, it just does. Maybe I'm wrong. I am wrong. Common's appearance on it is fire. The beat's fire. Mm-hmm. The tempo of it, the simplicity of it, versus a legendary song that has gone on to produce R&B versions of it. Mm-hmm. Shout out to Maya, which has gone on to have a whole new life via TikTok and Instagram these days, featuring this little white boy named Miles. On, I'm sure you guys have all seen it. Yeah. Where he's recreating the beat, this little genius.
Crazy.
This little genius is recreating. So again, the lifespan of this record is back again. It's been featured in numerous movies, and obviously it made its own noise when it actually dropped. It is actually the most popular song on this album when you're looking at Spotify numbers, for example. Mm-hmm. You're looking at 22 million plays, streams, right? Wow. For Drop, with 77 million for Running.
Wow.
Overall, their most popular record from this album.
They're talking about Running.
I am talking about Running.
Just Drop.
No, Drop was at 22 million, and then Running is at 77 million. So I thought it made kind of sense to pick two of the hottest songs. Doesn't matter, streams. That was just little nuggets I wanted to throw, little bullet points. But we're talking about The Business feature in Common versus Running. Who do you got? Who want to step up? Chat room, what are you thinking about? You know, so matter of fact, Hobo, do you mind giving us quick little
snippet?
Just a little snip.
Bass up the track a little bit, because I want to hear that boom, boom. You know what I'm saying?
So, they lie. Get out of the chaos. Ah. Don't do it like this.
I speak the mind of God theories, no need to be high. Only exhale and action, I don't inhale life. Play the greater man's game to bounce off my losses, so I could earn the acres, the houses, the support. Much greater than your Benz and your Lexus. The engine to my comprehension is just too complex. Much too complex. Effects be live like dots. Make your move down south to avoid the chaos. Flaunt the coin, cause dime getters be gay. They call me Luther Van, they say my style is so amazing.
That to me is an instrumental you could throw on, and it's time for the spitters to step up. Like, listen, like you either gonna spit or just give up the mic.
Sit your ass down.
Yeah, sit your ass down. But this beat requires somebody to go the fuck off. Again, we're talking about that track versus Running. The very popular, as we both all know, Running.
Oh man.
Chicken at three. Wondering why everybody always picking on me. I try to talk and tell them, till I decided nothing to deserve this. But when it didn't work, I wasn't scared, just real nervous and I'm prepared to deal with rapping on down. My pappy never told me how to knock a nigga out, but now we're 95 with a survival to man on my own.
Fuck around with that lip, yes, to get blown.
I feel like they're both very up to par with each other. Like I said, we don't never mind the numbers.
Yeah,
both these songs, they are. Productions and rhyme bounce and flows on them are ridiculous. The chat room, I'm definitely want to know where the fuck y'all stand. Yes, Douglas Houser, I was gonna bring it up. I'm glad you wrote it first. Yo, Matt Skills passed on this beat. That is in Douglas.
Ow.
Matter of fact, wait, Douglas Houser, check this out. I think we both might be wrong with what we just said. So I think I read an article that said he had bought three beats. Two of them ended up on the album. Mm-hmm. And the third one, in that interview, I can't remember what the third one is. I can't remember. And then he brought it up in something. I don't know where. It could have been online. It could have been Instagram. The third beat that he did not record to was Running. So he actually did pick the beat, technically. Passed on it by probably just not working on it. But he technically chose it. He technically paid for it.
It was on Instagram. He posted. Right? He posted. He said he found the beat tape, and
it was Running.
And he was like, "Listen to this," and it was Running. He's like, "And I didn't record it."
Yep. So he technically paid for the beat. He bought three, and the rest of the story was something like that's the first placement that Dilla ever got, and he was like, "Yo, I think he gave him $3,000 per track." So basically, he walks away with what, like $9,000, right? He's like, he said, yo, like, you have no idea what this means to me. Live. This is Matt Skills telling the story. He said, like, you can forever. He said, forever, like, you can forever get like a beat from me at 3,000. He's like, I never took him up on it ever again. It was like a thing that he was just like, yo, I'm always like forever. Like, you can always get a beat from
me. Messed up, son.
It's beautiful shit. I'm glad I'm not that high that I didn't fuck that story up. I think that's exactly how it goes. But if it doesn't, I really apologize. I didn't mean to nori that story up. But and I mean that with all love. I mean that all due love and respect. Again, listen, we're jumping around, people. Chat room, I need to know what's going on. What the fuck? We're talking about two gems. I love both those fucking records.
Yeah.
Specifically, as much as I don't even want to take away from the fucking artists themselves, the beats. The beats are fucking stupid for both them songs.
Yeah.
So we're talking about Paulo Coelho, right? Am I right, Scam?
Yeah.
On the sample, just ridiculous. I think we still might be wrong. But either way, regardless, who do you got? Let me know. Chat room, let me know. Room, let me know. Who's going? Whose vote's not going to matter? What's up? Who's stepping up?
Douglas Houser picked Running. He said it's one of the greatest hip-hop songs ever.
He don't even got to explain why. It's true. He's fucking true.
I chose running because it has like a metaphor. Like you can imagine it, like the implications of your life. What's going on in your life?
Nice. That's what you got from that. Okay. Nice. Yeah. Nice. Okay. That's what's up. Mm-hmm. The trip's getting all deep.
Philosophical.
You know what I'm saying? I didn't know he was deep, bro.
I go back to my hut.
About the birds. It is sage, baby. Before I just pretend it's some sage, I'm burning sage for you, baby.
I love both of these records, but I think Running is just the more iconic hip hop record, hands down.
Wow.
Both are classics. To me, they represent two different fields, too. I think the business, like you said, is the one that the spitters and the real MCs and hip hop heads can get on. But Running to me, like you mentioned earlier, it went to more the R&B genre too. I mean, you know, people assemble it and use it to sing over. So
we got Common on the business. And Common business, drops fucking fire as fucking usual.
Yeah.
He's on the C to the O to the M O N.
Yeah, Running to me is just the bigger record. It's the one that we're entering February. So, you know, it's Dilla month coming up too. So you already know you about to hear Running all month.
Yeah. So okay. So you got your vote down. Fair enough. Does anybody else want to step in the arena?
I will.
Malcontent, what are we thinking here?
All right. So yeah, I am sticking with my team. You know, I'm sticking with Lab Cabin because with Running. But I'm gonna point out one thing. Like I'm a, you know, and Hobo knows this. I really, really, really get into like bars and lyrics, and man, the business, man. And so every time I hear that mess, I'm just kind of like, man, they killed it. You know what I mean? They all went off.
Yeah.
And I mean, of course, like the boom back, the next snap of it. I love the business. But
definitely a next snapper for sure.
But one thing I'm gonna say with Running, man, Running, for one thing, for me, I'm like, you know, little bit of an old hit. And I love old school, and I love the way they put in the you know, the rock box sample, and I love the kind of run. I just love that today.
Do we know who's scratching on this record, by the way?
We do not.
Does anybody in the chat room, can anybody figure that out? Can anybody look that up? In my research today, I mean, I wasn't looking that up, but I something I would have definitely paid attention to had it just been on the page. But he's killing it, exactly.
The one last thing I was going to say was that I don't know, you know, speaking of videos, we know that Far Side is nice with the videos. I don't know if y'all peeped this in the video, but they did a reverse slavery thing in this video. It was so dope. It was so dope.
I gotta watch the video. I just remember they have suits in the video. That's all I remember. Just suits.
And they were slave owners. They were slave owners, and the white people were slaves.
Yes.
And the white and black people were the slave owners.
I don't remember. Yeah. I gotta watch the
video.
It was back in 1995, bro. Like, no one was even thinking like to do something like this.
That's crazy.
Yep. It's just wild.
Shout out to always just being innovative. Them dudes are always innovative.
Yeah.
This leaves a cool breeze and DJ Hobo. What are we thinking about?
I'm gonna go with 1995. Running, man.
You're gonna run as well.
Yeah, it's the beat, that guitar, sick, man.
It is a nice guitar, strum.
Yeah, it is, man.
That is the best part of shout out to all the dope fans for sending information out. It scratches. Apparently on running.
Yeah.
Damon Savage, Mark Ray, and Mark One.
Well, Justin Anthony said M Walk. Is that the same person?
That is.
M Walk is one of the producers on the album. So he might, there's a possibility the producer could have been the DJ as well. And if that's him, he killed that. So we have Breeze, Hobo. You know what time it is, bro. I'll give you a chance. We could try something new this week. Like you, but it's got to be a version of humiliation involved. Whether it's you laying down yourself, like
preemptive strike. I already know it don't count, but I just have to say, like running, it's like you said, that guitar.
Yeah, it doesn't matter what you say. You get shut down, brother. This is the power of being last. Accept that.
Can unmute myself, right?
Accept that. Your vote doesn't matter.
I don't accept your tyranny. I'm speaking my peace.
This is the host. You show me some respect.
I don't know.
We don't know which way we're going without me. You understand? Oh. All you keep asking me is, are we there yet?
I come on this show to talk, so I'm going to talk, damn it.
Okay. Listen. Your little vote don't matter, but okay, speak your mind.
I mean that guitar, man, it touches something. Pause.
This is why you want me to let him speak. You looking at me. You need to be looking at him.
It's very melodic, man, and it can't be denied, bro. Can't be denied.
You know what it is? It's Brazilian.
I was going to say that.
It's natural. It's like me. Brazilian, in case you didn't know, I'm Brazilian. It's natural, baby.
Here we go.
It's natural.
Here we go. All right.
Come on, man. This is how we do. We just smooth like that. Just like them chords. Listen, it doesn't matter what Hobo's vote is, even though he's voting for running. I'll put his vote down. But at the end of round number two, when we asked the overall question, what was the better overall track? When we're talking about certain songs from both these legendary albums, Stasis High versus Lab Cabin California. Looks like it's an overall resounding one-sided vote for, again, The Far Side. With Running being the overall tip scaler in this particular situation. So the score is 2-0 with The Far Side in the lead.